So, when you compose normally, do you follow any particular mindset, or these come naturally to you? Because I'm always intrigued as to how a tabla composition in today's times people are making. I mean, I don't know the process, right? I write poems, so I know how a person writes poems. So, मेरे लिए पहले वो मीटर होता है पोएम का, देन आई मेक श्योर कि वो यमक गमक इन प्लेस है. एंड देन साइमल्टेनियसली एक थॉट का फ्लो होना चाहिए. दैट इज हाउ आई राइट माई पोएम, राइट? सो द कॉम्पोजिशन दैट यू आर मेकिंग, कुड यू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट अ कपल ऑफ योर कॉम्पोजिशन वाया पढ़ंत?
I will tell you a thing. As the way which you said that you compose the compositions and all,
Yes.
same kind of thought process goes on into the composer's mind of tabla also. Okay.
Okay.
But about me, what happens, I just don't know what is happening.
Okay.
But
Right.
this is the way it happens, like this. You are correct.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It is the same way it happens with tabla composers.
Okay. Okay. That's heartening to know, because you know, when you don't know something, you always are more amazed at
Curious.
that thing,
Yeah.
and
Yeah.
curious and amazed
Yeah.
both. So yeah, that's great to know. So would you mind reciting a couple of your compositions,
Yeah,
the
yeah.
ones that you have
So,
created?
yeah, yeah. So this is a kind of. I was, in fact, very much amazed with a composition which I heard from Sopanji.
Okay. Okay.
That is a Anaghat Gar. I will recite that composition first. Then
Okay.
what I thought and what I did.
Are
I
wonderful.
will tell you that. Huh?
Wonderful, wonderful. Yes,
That is an Anaghat composition. What is this Anaghat composition means? Anaghat composition means, Anaghat is the composition which lands before the sum. What is the sum? The first syllable of the sum. Of the, sorry, the first syllable of the tala.
Yes. Or the
Which
first beat
means the
in that
starting
cycle.
point. Yeah. Starting point. Huh?
Right.
Which lands before the sum. That is anaghat.
Yes. Wonderful.
So this is composed, means what Sopanji tells us, that this composition is made by Ustad, the greatest compositions of all times, Hussain Khan.
Okay.
Ustad Abid
Abid
Hussain
Hussain
Khan.
Khan. Okay, okay,
Yeah.
okay.
So he was the greatest composer of his time.
Okay. Okay.
So the composition is Dha din din da rak din din da Dha din din da da. So this is the taal. Dha din din da rak din din da. Dhaget ta kita dhaget ta kita din din gede na din din. Dhaget ta kita to na kita ta kita ta kita gede na ta kita da. Dike na da da din da ta da ta So that is the composition which he composed. So what I thought, or what came from my mind was dha din din da tak din din da. Dada, kita didi, kita nakita ta na dhetta. Kritik dha, kita tat dhuma kita tat. Pradheti tat kata gentara, tirgita tat na pradheti tat. Dharagdingi tirgadingi na dhagetta kata dhakran. Dharagdingi tirgadingi na dhagetta kata dhakran. Dharagdingi tirgadingi na dhagetta kata dhakran. Din,
हाँ हाँ
din,
ये बात ये बात
din, din,
सुभान अल्लाह
din, din, dhage, trak, dhage, tat, dha. So,
क्या बात?
That way it happened.
Wonderful, wonderful.
That is my. But
That
I
is
think it's like
so mesmerizing. And it was, I mean, even for a person who might not understand the language that much, the way you manage the flow of that composition, that is something else.
इसीलिए तो पढ़ना
हाँ
for
हाँ
students who must be listening to this podcast, the syllables which are taught to you by your Guruji or your teacher, you should recite it couple of hundred times. After reciting for so many years, you can deviate your composition in any which way you want.
Right. Absolutely, absolutely. It's like we were taught in the school, learn your tables first.
kind of. And Yogesh Ji, Pandit Yogesh
Shamsi Ji. Yes.
Yeah. So, वो कहते हैं कि उन्होंने तबला सीखने की जो शुरुआत की वो पढ़न से ही शुरुआत की. अब्बा जी जो थे माने जाकिर भाई के पिताश्री, वो उनको तबला देते ही नहीं थे. आप बैठिए इधर और पढ़न कीजिए पहले.
No wonder his padhant is like a flow of water. And it is not even a tongue twister, guys. If you there are chances that some of you might not know who Pandit Yogesh Shamsi Ji is. Just Google his name, find out any video, and when he stops, his tabla playing is, he's a magician. But even when he recites the bowls or the syllables that we guys call as padhant, you try to understand every syllable. It is even difficult to comprehend what he's saying. He's that fast and he's that fluid. So, yeah, I'm again, that is one aspect about tabla playing that I'm mesmerized about, because personally, my tongue is quite hard and all these things are big tongue twisters for me. So, it's also a case I didn't learn tabla, but still, it's a very wonderful thing to just listen to anybody's padhan. So, yes, moving forward, this is a question that is often discussed in our music circles, you know. And any answer that I get, I always have some fodder to think about after the conversation. The Vidya or the lineage of music that we guys come from, it is at least a couple of thousand years old. But in today's zamana of globalization, there is no such one concrete avenue where our music is concentrated. So the entire music fraternity right now is divided into whether they should project themselves more and in that process play anything to the point where they start diluting their content, or they go by the traditional route and stick to what the traditional norms of their music want them to play. Now, I also know that the challenges involved in today's generation are real and they are there to stay. So, in this aspect, for example, take the case of fusion, or not just fusion actually, the manner in which the playing and singing has changed. What do you have? Do you have it? I mean, I'm sure you have a take on that. So I would like to know what that take is. Because even in the case of tabla, as I pointed out in the earlier conversation, students are more willing to put themselves out there, and it's not a bad thing in general, but they barely know how to play the dadra or the trital, and the next thing you know, they are the main rhythmist in a particular band, and that band is touring the country, but these guys, they haven't done their riyaz, and the next thing you know, when they play for even half an hour or 1 hour, their entire body, right from their hair to their hips, everything starts paining, and that proves that they haven't done their homework. So how do you look at these things? Because I think the people that are watching, the younger generation that is watching, they need to understand the viewpoints of established musicians like you in this aspect. So I would like to know your thoughts on that.
I would like to tell you something that is fusion and classical music. Both are completely different forms.
Right.
If you really want to listen classical music, you have to dug in.
Right, right.
I know that classical music is not that easy to. I'm not saying that it is completely impossible, but it is a bit, what we can say, a bit harder to learn and to get to know what is happening.
Right.
I know it is, but there was a cult in society which used to tell that khasa wo din apne wo sur thoda sa theek nahi lagaya wo dangal kuch theek nahi hui hame acha nahi laga. That was the cult in the society.
Okay.
And that cult was predominant while music scenario was explained. Which is completely vanished in past years.
Interesting.
So, to what we can say, so to deliver your stuff to the people and keep its sanctity and authenticity, you have to first tell them what it is. As we discussed earlier, this is completely abstract.
Right.
So, you cannot directly start delivering the heavy compositions. The people will be like, what he is doing? Let's close the chapter and leave.
Right.
Isn't it?
True.
So, you have to deliver it as if you are telling what we are going to do.
Today,
if a classical musician starts doing or starts delivering like this, people will again rejoin to classical music, I feel.
Wonderful.
And about fusion, I feel if you have a very unique and different something composition in your mind, you can definitely fuse it nicely.
Right.
But if you are taking one bandesh, a very old traditional bandesh, and you are just throwing in some other instrumental music with that, that does not create any kind of fusion music.
That is confusion. Probably.
So that is the way I feel.
Yes, totally.
But doing classical thing is very important because it has a very depth, we can call it as depth to the subject, and that depth is more important than just entertainment, I feel. That depth can make you cry. That depth can make you happy. That depth can take you to another possibility.
Yes.
Whenever you are dealing with classical music.
Wonderful. That's such a beautiful answer. And like we are almost in the last question or last couple of questions. I always make it a point to ask my fellow musician friends about this one thing. Do you in particular as a person feel that since you started your riyaz seriously to pursue tabla professionally, have you found yourself spiritually more at peace? Does tabla give you that meditative state? Because I've heard this from a lot of people, and people say that they might, some of them say I wasn't ever religious, some say that I was, but the one answer that they give me is that spiritually they think that they go to some other place and that their mind is much settled than it was earlier. So, is that the case with you? What is your experience in this regard?
Like, yes.
in terms of peace of mind, basically.
Yeah. It happens.
Okay.
ये जो वाद्य यंत्र है ये बहुत कुछ करवा सकता है, बहुत कुछ करवा सकता है, and that बहुत कुछ has a deep meaning, I feel.
Yes.
So if you are completely surrendered to this instrument, as Zakir bhai always says, Zakir ji, that this instrument has a what we can say, a different kind of power, soul to it. It has a different kind of power. If you surrender yourself to this instrument, it can lead you to meditational harmony.
Wow.
That can happen.
That's
for that, you have to practice, you have to maintain a relation with your instrument. You have to be in that zone for a couple of years. Then it can definitely happen.
So, Vikrant, I think this is probably the last question. And I know hum, on one hand, we are quite young and we have decades and decades of professional life ahead of us. But yes. We also have a certain amount of experience in whichever profession we are in. So in this context, you know, I come across many people, probably they are of our age as well, aur jo bolte hai ki humko genuinely bahut ye guitar sikhni hai, tabla sikhna hai, harmonium sikhna hai, piano sikhna hai, aur kuch sikhna hai. बट ना उम्र का हमेशा हमको लिहाजा खुद का ऐसा लगता है कि अभी थोड़ा लेट हो गया है या थोड़ी शर्म आ रही है. देन मुझे ऐसे भी बच्चे मिलते हैं जो बोलते हैं कि हमको करना है पर हमको कैसे करना है ये नहीं पता है. मतलब क्या माइंडसेट लेके हम इस चीज में उतरे? शुड वी एक्सपेक्ट एनीथिंग फ्रॉम अस इन द बिगिनिंग इटसेल्फ और शुड वी जस्ट स्टार्ट डूइंग ये? और ये मतलब when I look back, when I was like 10 or 11 years old, that was the first time I actually started my music classes. और ये सब ख्याल मेरे मन में भी आते थे क्योंकि मेरे लिए somehow time pass होता था sports and passion follow करना अगर होता है like something apart from studies, वो हमेशा music होता था. पर मुझे बहुत देर तक मेरी लाइफ में समझा ही नहीं कि मैं किस एटीट्यूड से इस चीज की तरफ देखूं. सो और मुझे नहीं बताया गया था अनफॉर्चुनेटली, ना मैंने किसी से पूछा, वो भी बात है. तो व्हाट वुड यू टेल तो किड्स लाइक देम और इवन वर्किंग प्रोफेशनल, कैसे देखना चाहिए उनको, कैसे स्टार्ट करना चाहिए एंड क्या स्पेस होनी चाहिए उनके माइंड की?
Okay, as we again going to the same point, as we discussed earlier, you should be a clear slate.
Right.
First. उसके बाद होता है ऐसा है कि सीखने के लिए उम्र नहीं होती, ये अभी तक हमारे इधर ऐसे imbibe नहीं किया गया है.
Ah, wonderful.
That is a socio problem, I feel.
Absolutely.
Learning has no age barrier.
Right.
No age barrier.
Right.
Even panoramic view of, about learning, every person, it is said, there is a paper research published in some other country abroad, that a person is always learning till he is completely bedridden or something. Mm.
Mm.
Till then he is learning. तो ऐसी बात है, तो सीखने के लिए हिचकिचाहट नहीं होनी चाहिए. So I teach to a long age group, like it starts from age of 6 or 7 to the age of 55. I have a student, three students, in fact, I have four students who are around the age of 50, 52, 48.
Wonderful. Wonderful. That is so heartening to hear.
Yeah. So, and they're doing a quite good job. Huh?
Yes.
They're learning it very, very, very obediently, I will say.
So,
and they're leading to a very great path has been. Mm. In fact, they only tell me that after playing, we feel like, yo, we did a good job today.
I think that is the most important thing. No?
That is the freshness. That is the freshness of playing any kind of instrument or any kind of art or doing any kind of art. Some people do sketching or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
It is one and all the same thing. It leads to the same point, I feel.
So true. So true man, ये हमको somehow इसका opposite ही हमको हमेशा बताया जाता है कि ये तुम्हारी कोई उम्र है करने की and हमारे पास तो मुहावरे भी है ये गलत चीज पे मुहावरे है हमारे पास which is the most
that is the socio problem, nothing else.
That is a socio problem. So yes guys, you heard it from Mr. Vikrant, ना तो सीखने की कोई उम्र नहीं होती है. So that was a wonderful talk and honestly मुझे बहुत सारी चीजें ऐसी पता चली है जो मुझे पहले पता नहीं थी. So मेरे ज्ञान में भी घर थोड़ा भंडार में थोड़ी भर पड़ गई है तो मुझे उस बात की भी अच्छा महसूस हो रहा है obviously. And yes guys, before I forget, a couple of things. I'll be attaching the links or I'll be just displaying the link for Vikrant Facebook, Insta handle, and other contact information, whatever he's willing to. So any of you guys are interested, please contact him. Vikrant is actively into teaching tabla. Of course, he'll wo aapki chhanbeen karenge acche se. He'll first make sure that you are sincere enough to learn under him. But of course, you have to go through that grind. Because if there is a college, then the college also has to entrance exam. So, it is no different. But
people don't have any problem when they start to learn.
Yes.
But just that push has to be there. Someone has to push them very hardly. That no, there is no kind of limit. That you should bang on and start.
Yes. Most important. And उनकी बातों से आपको पता चला ही होगा. Because मेरे personal experience से बोलूँ तो गुरु मैंने किए दो तीन किए. लेकिन मैं किसी का मतलब तीन या चार गुरु थे मेरे साथ. किसी का नाम नहीं लूँगा. हर एक गुरु ने मुझे बहुत दिया है गाने में. But हर इंसान की psychology अलग होती है. कोई थोड़े गुस्सेल होते हैं. कोई आपके साथ कनेक्ट करने में इंटरेस्टेड नहीं होते. और जब ऐसे गुरु आपको मिलते हैं जिनके पास नॉलेज तो बहुत है लेकिन थोड़े उनके खुद के रुतबे अलग हैं, तो उस टाइम आप जब छोटी उम्र के होते हो स्पेशली आप टीनेज में हो, आपके मेंटल इवोल्यूशन हुआ नहीं है पूरे तरीके से, देन यू कैन गेट इंटिमिडेटेड बाय दैट पर्सन एंड देन यू माइट ऑल्सो स्टॉप लर्निंग म्यूजिक डांस ड्रामा जो भी है एंड यू माइट ऑल्सो स्टार्ट हेटिंग इट बिकॉज वो बहुत ही वल्नरेबल एज होता है आई फील. तो सही गुरु मिलना बहुत इसेंशियल है हर मायने में, नॉट जस्ट नॉलेज बट अप्रोचेबिलिटी एंड एवरीथिंग. सो यस दैट वॉज अ वेरी
और उसके बारे में एक और चीज इसके बारे में मुझे एक बात बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट लगती है. अच्छा गुरु मिलने के लिए उतना ही तुम्हें अंदर से चाह होनी चाहिए. तो सब हो जाता है, सब कनेक्ट हो जाता है, इट गेट्स कनेक्टेड.
सही बात.
जस्ट सम पीपल हैज टू स्ट्राइव हार्ड. आई नो बट
यू गेट इट. यू फर्स्ट हैव टू हैव दैट स्ट्रॉन्ग इंटेंशन कि मुझे ये चीज सीखनी है, और आपको जो देख रहे हो उसमें से आप में से कोई तो होगा परसेंटेज जिनको पता है आपको तबला सीखना है, तो किसके पास जाना है अभी आपको पता है तो डिस्क्रिप्शन में विक्रांत के कॉन्टेक्ट
वेलकम and Apurva, basically I'm very glad to have a nice talk and thought sharing with you.
Yes,
definitely.
क्योंकि हम लोग जब मिलते हैं तो मेरे म्यूजिक के दोस्त और मेरा थोड़ा सा यही प्रॉब्लम है, क्योंकि दोस्त इतने पुराने और इतने अच्छे बन गए ना, तो बातें सब होती है, म्यूजिक की ही होती है, ऐसी नहीं है. म्यूजिक के अलावा भी बहुत सारी अच्छी अच्छी बातें होती है. तो ये जो एक जरिया है मिला है ना मुझे, इसकी वजह से मैं मेरे म्यूजिक वाले दोस्तों के साथ सिर्फ म्यूजिक की बातें करता हूँ, तो मुझे तो कोई और ही मजा आ जाता है उसी बहाने में. तो मेरे लिए एक बोलते ना मराठी में एक वर्ड है स्वांत सुख. स्वांत सुख माने द फीलिंग ऑफ सुख जो आपको अंदर से खुश कर देता है बहुत. तो उस कुछ ऐसा हो जाता है मेरे साथ. And we are almost at the end of this podcast.
Inner happiness.
But, something beyond inner happiness. Inner contentment. I think that is a better word.
Wow.
हाँ, मतलब सुकून मिल गया और कुछ अच्छा हो गया जो रहेगा मेरे साथ एंड तक, ऐसा फीलिंग आ जाता है. तो ये पॉडकास्ट गाइज ऑलमोस्ट खत्म हो गया है. मैं बस थोड़े फॉर्मेलिटी के तौर पे दो वर्ड बोलूंगा. फॉर्मेलिटी सही नहीं है पर बोलना पड़ता है, एक यू नो क्लोजर मिल जाता है वो चीज को, इसीलिए मैं बोल रहा हूँ. तो आफ्टर व्हाटएवर आई से फिनिशेस, आई विल रिक्वेस्ट विक्रांत टू प्ले सम कॉम्पोजिशंस और मे बी रिसाइट सम कॉम्पोजिशंस दैट ही वॉन्ट्स टू, अगर प्लेइंग के टेक्निकल डिफिकल्टीज कुछ हो रही है. बिकॉज The thing that is happening, guys, is we are using very average technical setup. क्योंकि lockdown होगा किसी को पता नहीं था, तो हमारे पास जो available electronic devices है उनका जो भी basic processing power है उस हिसाब से ये सब recording चल रहा है. तो maybe
and the portal has a major problem.
Yes.
With musical instruments, I feel.
Yes. But our music is such that it penetrates through difficult internet and difficult electronic
devices. It can penetrate just by reciting also.
Yes, yes.
It is so powerful.
Yes, absolutely. I completely agree with that point. So maybe he'll recite, maybe he'll play like jo unka mood hai, jaisa hai abhi. And
bajane ke liye to मूड होता ही है, पर क्या है आज तो वो
yes. सब थोड़ी गड़बड़ हो रही है. कोई बात नहीं, वो रिट्राइट करेंगे.
पोर्टल का भी प्रॉब्लम है.
आई अंडरस्टैंड.
वो माइक कैच ही नहीं कर रहा है.
आई अंडरस्टैंड. तो विक्रांत के और भी वीडियोस हैं, उनको बेसिकली फॉलो कीजिए. इंस्टा हो उनका, फेसबुक हो उनके, यूट्यूब वीडियोस आई एम श्योर रहेंगे, वहां पे जाओ. उनका खुद का एक फेसबुक का पेज है, ये सब लिंक्स में डालने वाला हूँ. मैं बस बोल रहा हूँ कि आपको रिमाइंड हो.
राइट. एंड इफ यू वांट टू नो मोर अबाउट माय टीचिंग बैकग्राउंड, जस्ट लॉग इन टू माय पेज ऑन फेसबुक कॉल्ड एज तालम तबला इंस्टीट्यूट.
इसकी भी लिंक हम डालेंगे डिस्क्रिप्शन में, सो दैट सब साथ में मिल जाएगा दोस्तों को. एंड इनका इंस्टीट्यूट भी आई थिंक करवे नगर एरिया में ही है, पुणे के, इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग.
पुणे के करवे नगर
कोथरूड एरिया में ही है. तो खैर वो फेसबुक पेज पे सब इंफॉर्मेशन मिल ही जाएगी आपको. जो भी है उनका, उनको आपको कैसे कॉन्टेक्ट करना है, उनका नंबर या जो भी है, यू विल फिगर इट आउट देयर. उनका ईमेल आईडी मैं देता हूँ. He is also active on his email, so that एक official communication का जरिया भी हो जाएगा आप लोगों को विक्रांत के साथ. विक्रांत thank you so much, seriously it was fun for me, मुझे बहुत मजा आ गया. मेरी आज की दोपहर रंगीन हो गई है, अभी शाम होते आई, 2-3 घंटा हम ये कर रहे हैं. मजा आ गया. ये लॉकडाउन में मुझे इतना अच्छा जरिया मिल गया है ना, मेरी कुछ कुछ इवनिंग्स और दोपहर इतनी मार्वलस जाती है, मैं रिचार्ज हो जाता हूँ, और उसी बहाने फिर मेरे आगे के कुछ दिन मजे में जाते हैं.
क्या बात है, बहुत अच्छा.
तो एंड द बेस्ट पार्ट इज, यस एंड द बेस्ट पार्ट इज विक्रांत और मेरा ट्यूनिंग ऐसा है कि मैंने विक्रांत को ऐसा बहुत सोचा था कि देखो मैंने ये वीडियो बनाया है ये तुम देखो फिर तुम ये करोगे वो करोगे. मैंने जब ये आइडिया डिस्कस की थर्ड सेंटेंस में विक्रांत ने मुझे स्टॉप करके बोला हाँ हम कर लेंगे चल. सो दैट इज द काइंड ऑफ अप्रोचेबल पर्सन दैट विक्रांत इज. सो यस दैट्स अबाउट इट. मैं अभी मेरी बड़बड़ बंद करता हूँ. विक्रांत तुमको जो भी बोलना है लास्ट में
we'll recite some propositions and then we will conclude.
Yes. Okay. कुछ viewers को last sentences बोलने हैं तो वो भी बोल सकते हो. आपका recitation हो जाएगा and then उसके बाद हम खत्म कर देंगे podcast.
Yeah. So viewers के लिए यही है कि first you be a humble person, you be a clear slate, and after that obedience always pays off. एंड ये लॉकडाउन खत्म हो जाएगा, इतना टेंशन मत लो. हालांकि बहुत बहुत कुछ देखने मिल रहा है जो अच्छा नहीं हो रहा है, पता है, पर फिर भी कहीं तो संयम का बांध रखना जरूरी है. तो हम वो सब बनाए रखेंगे और अच्छे साल की कामना करके आगे बढ़ेंगे.
Wonderful.
So there are a few compositions. Yes, some are very old.
The stage is all yours. आपको इतना
recitation करना है आप करो. Today we will recite in the later part. If we get chance, then we will play.
Yes.
Again, in some other place and all with a good setup and all. This is a firework composition.
Okay.
Why it is called as firework? Because when it ends, it's like वो firecracker की जो ये लो जो जलती हुई आती है आकाश से नीचे, तो वो लो को देखा गया कि थुन 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 थुन.
क्या बात है.
उसके कंपोजर है उस्ताद अबीर हुसैन खान, अगेन लखनऊ, उस्ताद अबीर हुसैन खान. इसको हम ऐसे देख सकते हैं कि मियां बीवी में झगड़ा हो रहा है और थोड़ी देर बाद वो सम अप कर लेते हैं. This is what I tried to compose. This was my composition. That was again my composition.
बेहतरीन.
ऐसा कुछ चलता रहता है दिमाग में.
भगवान की देन है. वंडरफुल. एंड आपकी मेहनत भी है.
ब्लेसिंग. कंप्लीटली अ ब्लेसिंग, नथिंग एल्स. कंप्लीटली अ ब्लेसिंग.
वंडरफुल वंडरफुल वंडरफुल. लेट्स जस्ट स्टॉप बिकॉज मुझे इसके आगे कुछ बोलने का मन नहीं कर रहा है. आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू
कीप नेवर यूज इट.
यस थैंक यू सो मच विक्रांत. It was great fun and hope आपके आपका लाइव तबला जल्दी से जल्दी हम सब लोगों को सुनने को मिल जाए। एंड इसी बहाने मेरी आपसे एक दरख्वास्त है कि आप खुद का कुछ यूट्यूब पे वीडियोस डालेंगे अपने लोगों के लिए इवेंचुअली, तो हम जैसे लोगों के लिए बहुत आसानी हो जाएगी और मजा आ जाएगा।
So you we'll do it. It. We'll do it definitely.
Yes, on that note, guys, thank you so much. I know, as always, this is also a long podcast. It will be edited into a couple of episodes. But as I always say, I try to make sure ki kuch achha deke jau aapke liye. Aisa hi kuch content banane se koi matlab nahi hai. There should be something that you take away home, that you think about, you have fun, you learn something. And that is the motto for me in this lockdown. And आपका भी वैसा ही होना चाहिए, because as I always say, आपने कुछ सीखा नहीं है lockdown में, तो आपने क्या किया? कुछ अच्छा सीखो, कुछ अच्छा सुनो, कुछ अच्छे thoughts लाओ, work upon yourself. Life is wonderful. हमको एक बुरी चीज की वजह से break मिल गया, लेकिन ये break का हम कुछ अच्छा कर पाए तो nothing like it. God का ये जो speed breaker डाल दिया है God ने, वो उसको थोड़ा justice मिल जाएगा. एक नेगेटिव चीज पॉजिटिव चीज में कन्वर्ट हो जाएगी। ऑन दैट नोट थैंक यू सो मच, गॉड ब्लेस यू ऑल। विक्रांत नाथू, आई कैन नॉट बी थैंकफुल, आई कैन नॉट बी थैंकफुल, आई कैन जस्ट बी ग्रेटफुल टू यू कि आप आए, हमारी शाम रंगीन हो गई।
वेलकम वेलकम वेलकम।
दिस इज अपूर्व राहुल वक्त साइनिंग ऑफ। गाइज, स्टे ब्लेस, स्टे सेफ, स्टे हेल्दी एंड बी हैप्पी। थैंक यू सो मच।
सी यू। Hello.